Welcome back. I'm Debbie Crawford with Bridging the Gap, and we are here with Mitchell Welty. He's doing something really cool. How are you, Mitchell?
I'm doing well, thanks.
So you're doing an event this year.
I am.
What's that event?
We're calling it Fill the Wagon. What we're doing is taking toy donations or any item of clothing, anything like that. We need things for basically kindergartners through young adult. So anything in there, socks, underwear, toiletries are accepted. Any new item, small toys, and all that 100% will be donated to these families and stuff around the holidays.
And you've picked Saturdays that you're going to be at different places?
I have. We're going to do 5 Saturdays, every Saturday in November and the first Saturday in December.
And that'll cover Jefferson County, Indiana, and Trimble County, Kentucky.
That's correct.
Now, with those stops, what is it you're expecting people to do?
Well, if they could just bring any toy, like I said, any toy donation, socks, underwear, anything of that nature. Doesn't have to be wrapped. It does have to be new. That's just one of the requirements they have. And if you could just come by and drop it off, we're going to have a full-size radio flyer wagon car there. Put it in the car. If you don't want to make a donation, that's fine too. If you just want to come by and hang out, say hi, check out the wagon, that's absolutely welcome as well.
Now, there's going to be several places you're going to be at on those Saturdays. So where are some of the places they're going to be?
One stop will be Farm CBD, just located outside of Bedford. We'll also be at the Milton Dairy Queen. We'll be at the Milton Elementary School in the parking lot. And we'll go back to Farm CBD. And then our last stop of the year will be the first weekend in December. And that'll be immediately after the Christmas parade here in Madison, Indiana.
Oh, wow. You've got a lot going on.
It's
going
to be a busy month, but it'll be well worth it.
Now, with all that happening, there's that radio flyer wagon that you built. What encouraged you to do that? Why did you decide to up and build a wagon?
Well, several years ago, I'd seen where someone else had built a radio flyer wagon, and theirs was the metal body type of wagon.
Right.
And I'd threatened my wife for several years that I was going to do it, and one day I just decided to go ahead and do it. Ours is more the wood-sided one, more like the Town and Country Series wagon. And
right.
You know, it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a full-size, almost-to-scale radio flyer wagon. It seats 7 passengers, and, you know, we drive it everywhere.
But you didn't build it for any specific reason except the fact you enjoy to do that. And then
I mean, that's just what I like to do. I like to work with my hands, and I like to build interesting or strange things. Some people would call them useless things, but, you know, that's what I enjoy.
Yeah. But it turns out you found a purpose for it.
We hope so. We hope we found a good use for this. And, you know, it's built to make people smile, and it's built to be enjoyed. It's not your normal show car where it's don't touch, don't lean. This is climb in, take a seat, take your picture, take it around the block if you want to. I mean, this thing is built to be used.
So when they come to bring and drop off something, they can actually check out the wagon.
Absolutely.
And touch it.
Absolutely. Climb in, take your picture, put the kids on the hood. It's built to be enjoyed.
Now, I'm going to ask him a question I haven't asked him yet. Can anybody rent the wagon? You know, you're going to put it in other parades? And
you know, I've never really thought about renting the wagon, but I'll tell you a short story if we've got time.
Yes.
Over the weekend, you know, when you drive the wagon, you meet a lot of people. It's hard to meet somebody in a bad mood when you're in the wagon. I know that sounds strange, but you meet a lot of really interesting, cool people. Long story short, the lady reached out to us. We met her over the weekend, and she had a family that had a rough patch this year. Thought it would be bring a smile to their face, basically, to take them for a ride.
Yeah.
I said, absolutely, I'm all for it. Yesterday, we picked this young lady and her son and took them for a ride, and they absolutely loved it. So, you know, if you want to ride in the wagon, we'll try our best to make it happen.
Oh, wow. So, with all this donation stuff you're collecting, it's going to go to benefit what in Trimble County?
It'll be the Friskies program, which is through the schools with the youth program. And, you know, they do a lot to not only helping the kids get the stuff they need for school, during school, you know, after school. They actually help the families too. So, you know, it's a great program. And again, 100% of everything given will be donated to these programs.
Right. And then on the Jefferson County side,
that's going to the Lidewhite Boys and Girls Club.
Right.
Anything you want to donate to that will 100% go to Lidewhite Boys and Girls Club. And, you know, I think it's important that people know if you want it to go to Trimble County and you give in Trimble County, it's going to go to that community.
Yes.
And if you want to give in Madison, it's going to go to that community.
Yes.
So, you know, a lot of people, that's important to them, and it's important to us as well.
Well, that's great. So you're making sure it goes where they would like to see it go.
Sure.
That's wonderful. And is there anything else we need to let people know about all this?
I think that pretty well covers it, but yeah. You know, if you're unable to make one of the events, that's right. Absolutely fine. If you want to get together with your place of business or your place of employment and pool a bunch of stuff and have the wagon stop by and pick it up, we're absolutely fine with that too. We will make that happen.
And you can do that one day after work.
Absolutely.
This is not your job, obviously.
No, it's not. Unfortunately, it's not.
So you could drive the wagon over after work and pick up their stuff or on your day off.
Absolutely. Rain, snow, we'll make it happen.
Oh my goodness. When he says rain or snow, just so y'all know, that it is not covered. It is actually a wagon.
Yes, it is.
It's open.
Yes, it is.
Well, let's hope they do it on no rain and no bitter cold.
If it's really rainy or really cold, my wife will not be with me. I'll guarantee you that.
I'll get her some. Let me talk to her. We can get her some pretty good insulated clothes. She'll be fine. So, we'll try that. Well, thanks so much for being with us, Mitchell.
This I really is wonderful. Appreciate you having me.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Now, to keep up with the dates and times as to where Mitchell's going to be to fill the wagon, you'll want to check out November the 7th. It'll be at Farm CBD on 42, just outside of Bedford. And that'll be from noon to 3. On November the 14th, it'll be the Milton Dairy Queen on 421 North. That's downtown Milton. And that'll be from noon to 3. On November 21st will be the Milton Elementary School on 421 North, and that one will be from noon to 3. November 28th will be back at Farm CBD on 42, just outside of Bedford, from noon to 3. December the 5th will be 402 West Main in Madison, Indiana, right after the Very Merry Madison Christmas Parade, and that one will be from 1 to 3. And as always, we greatly appreciate our sponsors for making all this possible, and we thank you for watching.